Hi there, it's me again, Ollie, and today I would like to show you a new program I've made. This program is called OS Background Changer. It does exactly what it says. It allows you to change your OS backgrounds. It does this by modifying oseasonal.dll, which I will show you in a bit. And I also have another program I made a while ago, which was called OS In-Game Background Changer, which changes all bitmap backgrounds to a static image. So you can look for that in my GitHub. This is about OS Background Changer. It's very easy to use. I have some steps here on the GitHub page. However, I need content for this video, so I'll just show you it myself. So you can go to the release tab and download it here. This will give you a zip file. You can just extract this. And we'll give you a DLL and an exe. Run the exe and the program will open as you would expect. It's very blank right now, so you will have to open a file. The file it expects is oseasonal.dll, which contains seasonal background images for OS, as I will show you now. You can see you can see a little preview of every image by clicking on them. As you can see, these are the fan arts. These are the top 10 images from the OS fan art contest for Mocha, I think, the new mascot. This program allows you to, exchange these. It also actually allows you to export them, so if you press File, hit Export Image, you can save any image from this archive, which I think is kind of cool. You can double-click an image here, and it will open this file dialog, so you can navigate to all your favorite backgrounds and whatnot, and press click an image, and it will change it to that image. So this will be one of the backgrounds if you would save this and use it. Keep in mind that every image has a counterpart that's twice the size, so you have to change both if you wish to be able to use it on all resolutions. The version that's twice the size gets used if your OS resolution is above 720p, if I recall correctly. Anyway, make sure you modify this one too then. If you want to have like all your backgrounds, you can just hit Control A, like use one background all the time. Control A, you can just edit, replace, and select one background if you want, so you will always have the same. But like the main feature of this is that you can actually shuffle through various backgrounds. So you can just select your backgrounds by holding Control. You can select multiple entries. Press Edit, hit Replace, and select a new image. So now these two are this image. These are the one I selected first. And now I can do the same for the others. Edit, replace, select another image. You can also hit Control R, which is quicker because you have to do it a lot if you want to change all your backgrounds. So I'll do that now real quick as an example. You can also just like revert to other old backgrounds if you want, like this one for example, or this one, which is one I really like. There you go. What you can also do, by the way, is say you really like black backgrounds, you can just select them, hit edit and then clear, which will just replace them with a 1x1 pixel image, which for OS is essentially just will get enlarged in just a black pixel, so it will be a black background. And it saves some space as well. So once you have changed all images to your liking, you can save them to a place, whatever, as oseasonal.dll. And this can take a while because it has to serialize all the images, and my PC is just pretty crap as well, and it's not multi-threaded. But after a while it will be written to the folder you wish, and then you can use it. Now keep in mind that you should not... Is it done? Yes, it's done. Keep in mind that you should not paste this directly into your OS directory for a reason I will show now. So OS has the oseasonal.dll, you can just overwrite it by pasting my version, which is a lot larger, in here, and now you can run OS. However, you may notice that OS will try to update, usually. Yes, you can see in the bottom, downloading new oseasonal.dll. But you can see my custom background, and it has some strange artifacts because the image is too big. But if you change songs, you can see that the background changes as well, which is cool. Now I'm just gonna restart OS, and it will revert to the old OSseason.dll, the original one. But if you now close OS, and then you can just copy yours in again. That's not what I wanted, okay. There, you just copy it in again. This time, it will not try to override it because of like caches, bitmap hashes or something in the file, I'm not sure. So yeah, now it will not try to update. So this is the blank background I mentioned. It's just completely black. And you can like go to the next track and it will change the background as with normal seasonal backgrounds. So you can just loop through all your favorite images. And yeah. These also show up if you go to a bitmap that does not have a background, which is going to be a pain to find, so I won't. That's the program. It allows you to change backgrounds. As always, it's free on my GitHub. You can find the source. Little credit, I use the nlib for writing DLL files because it's easier than like reverse engineering the entire format. Anyway, yeah, it's licensed under the MIT license. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Also, keep in mind you are modifying OS files. It's technically not against rules, I think, because you can only not modify files for cheating. And this is not cheating unless this makes you play better somehow, I guess. Yeah, so use at your own risk and enjoy, I guess. Goodbye.